The Yankees have had plenty of captains and managers, but there's only been one boss. During more than 37 years as the team's principal owner, George M. Steinbrenner III turned the Bronx Bombers into a global powerhouse. He steered the franchise to success unmatched by any other in baseball while he was in charge, and his visionary leadership forever altered the way business is done in the major leagues. With a personality that matched his brilliance, George became an icon. His quotes made New York City newspapers essential reading. There are appearances in movies and on era-defining television shows. Now, even though times have changed, Steinbrenner is permanently etched in history among sports' most colorful figures. The landscape grew dull on this date in 2010 when George passed away at the age of 80. A decade later, the memories of this legendary man remain vivid for the people who were close to him. And we will hear from some of them today as we reflect upon his life and legacy. Monday afternoon in the Bronx, and the wrap-up to the 60-game Major League Baseball season continues with a Yankees workout day. It's Yankees Summer Camp on YES, presented by your local Ford stores. We certainly hope you're having a great day as we welcome you to our studio. Bob Lorenz, Jack Curry with you. We've got Michael Kay coming up, John Flaherty, Paul O'Neill, Meredith Morakovich, Susan Waldman. So many great memories of George Steinbrenner, and I know having covered him so much, you have a slew of memories.
George was this larger-than-life figure, Bob, the demanding owner. He loved the Yankees, and he loved winning, and I had the good fortune of interviewing him dozens of times, and every one of those conversations, that's what oozed out of his pores. This was a guy who wanted to figure out a way to help the Yankees win. He was at the beginning of free agency, spending money on players, bringing in a Reggie Jackson because he believed that would help the Yankees win, help them move forward. And again, he was demanding. He earned the name the boss, but his mission was get a championship for the Yankees, and they had seven of those during his ownership.
All right, so while you were on the beat, every reporter's goal was to get that headline-grabbing quote, right? So pick a word to describe trying to chase down the boss to get that quote.
I need two words, Bob. Okay. I think it's two words. It's a phrase. It's called nerve-wracking because you're absolutely right. Think of the days before cell phones when you're trying to reach out to George Steinbrenner and you're waiting for him to call you back in your hotel or your home, and you're wondering if your competitors are getting that same phone call back. And I can't express to you how joyous a moment it was when the phone rang, and George would always say, "This is George." He would never say hello, at least with me. He would just say, "This is George." And then after you had the interview, you call your editor. I was at the New York Times at the time, and I would say, "I got George." And you would hear their excitement. And Bob, their next question was, "Did you get him alone?" Now, of course, I never knew. Sometimes George would say, "You're the only reporter I'm calling back today." And then the next day, you'd pick up the newspapers because there wasn't any internet. You had to wait for the newspaper to hit the doorstep in front of you. He had called back four or five other reporters as well.